Article 255 of the revised penal code is infanticide. Let's go to elements. Number one, a child was killed. Number two, that deceased child was less than 3 days old or 72 hours of age. Number three, the accused killed the said child. Let's discuss element number one, a child was killed. If you will be confronted with a question, and ang namatay or yung pinatay is bata, you ask yourself, how old was the child? Was he or she less than 3 days old? Or was she or he exactly 3 days old or over? Bakit? Because if the child was less than 3 days of age, then the crime is infanticide. If he is exactly 3 days of age or over, then the crime is either parricide or murder. Kailan nagiging parricide? Nagiging parricide if the accused or the offender has a relationship with the victim as stated in Article 246 of the Revised Penal Code. Kailan naman nagiging murder? Nagiging murder kung walang relationship si accused kay victim. Because ano ang sabi ng Supreme Court? If you are going to kill a child of tender years, that is murder, even if the manner of attack is not shown. What is your qualifying circumstance? The qualifying circumstance is treachery. 2012, number 18, bar question, MCQ. What crime is committed by a person who kills a three-day-old baby? Choices are number one, infanticide, number two, homicide, three, murder, and the last choice is parricide. So since the child killed is already 3-day-old, then we have to eliminate infanticide. Hindi na pasok si infanticide. So ano na lang ang pagpipilian mo? Either murder or parricide. But in our problem, naka-indicate ba na may relationship yung bata sa accused? Meron bang relationship si accused sa victim? Hindi naka-indicate sa problem. Therefore, huwag tayong mag-assume. So, let's rule out also parricide. What is now the answer? The answer is murder. Bakit naging murder? Because sabi nga ng Supreme Court, if you are going to kill a child of tender years, that is murder. That is murder and your qualifying circumstance is treachery. Even if the manner of the attack is not shown, that is still murder. Let's go now to element number two. The deceased child was less than 3 days old or 72 hours of age. Take note ha, less than 3 days old or less than 72 hours of age. That means to say na bagong panganak yung baby. And speaking of bagong panganak, take note that the crime of infanticide is not committed where the child was born dead. Or even if the child was born alive, he could not sustain an independent life when he was killed. Bakit? Because the requirement of the law for you to be liable of infanticide is that child must be born alive and fully developed, which means that that child can sustain an independent life. But question, when can you consider a child born alive? Article 41 has the answer. Article 41 of the Civil Code. So, ito yung second Sunday mo and third Sunday mo na si criminal law. I hope that during your third Sunday, hindi nyo pa rin nakalimutan si civil law. So, when is a child considered born alive? Ano ang sabi ng Article 41? If that fetus had an intrauterine life of less than 7 months, then he will be considered alive if he will not die within 24 hours after its complete delivery from the maternal womb. Dapat hindi mamatay within 24 hours. But how about if the intrauterine life is 7 months or more? Then the fetus is considered born if it is alive at the moment it is completely delivered from the mother's womb. Let's read this 2006 bar exam question. Anna is a bar girl and she fell in love with Onyok. Sino si Onyok? He is a bartender who impregnated Anna. Onyok tried to persuade Anna to undergo an abortion, but Anna refused. Because of their constant and bitter quarrels, Anna suffered birth pangs and gave birth prematurely to a live baby girl while Onyok was at his place of work. Upon coming home and learning what happened, he prevailed upon Anna to conceal her dishonor. Hence, they placed the infant in a shoebox and threw it into a nearby creek. However, there is this neighbor who saw them, and with the help of others, they retrieved the infant who was already dead from the drowning. The incident was reported to the police officers who arrested Anna and Onyok. The two were charged with parricide, and after trial, they were convicted of the crime charged. Question, was the conviction correct? Definitely, the answer is no. Bakit? Because the crime here is not parricide. Bakit hindi parricide? Because in parricide, you have to make sure that the child is exactly 3 days old or over. So how about if the crime charged is infanticide? Was the conviction correct? Answer is, you have to make a distinction. Bakit? Kung hindi malinaw ang problem, kung who is that child, how old is that child, then you make a distinction. Bakit? Ano ang requirement sa infanticide? That child must be born alive. The child must be fully developed in such a way that it can sustain an independent life. Infanticide and parricide involves a killing where the victim is already a person. That is why you have to make a distinction. Ipasok nyo palagi sa sagot si Article 41 kung hindi sure, kung hindi malinaw ang facts ng problem. Let's go now to the last element. The accused killed the child. But who is the accused in the crime of infanticide? The accused is any person. Any person. So that person may be related to our victim or he has no relationship at all with our victim. This is the reason why if there is a stranger who cooperated with the mother in killing a child that is less than 3 days old, then the mother is guilty of infanticide. That stranger is also guilty of infanticide. Therefore, we can now say that the rule on conspiracy applies. The act of one is the act of all. In our case, or in that case, only one information is filed against all the offenders. But saan sila nagkakaiba? Saan nagkakaiba? Nagkakaiba sa penalty. Bakit? If you're going to read your Article 255, your Article 255 does not provide a penalty for infanticide. Ano ang nakasulat sa Article 255? The penalty that you will be imposing is the penalty for parricide or murder, but the name of the crime is always infanticide. So when are you going to impose that penalty for parricide? Answer, if the mother or the father or the legitimate other ascendant is your accused or is the person who killed the child that is less than 3 days old, then the penalty that you will be imposing is the one corresponding to parricide. Very clear yan. And what is the penalty for parricide? He shall be punished by the penalty of reclusion perpetua to death. Kailan naman nagiging penalty is the one for murder? If the offender is not related to the child, then the penalty corresponding to murder shall be imposed. What is the penalty for murder? According to Article 248, the person shall be punished by reclusion temporal in its maximum period to death. 1999 bar exam question. A. Killed their child who was only 2 days old. Question, what crime or crimes did A commit? Answer, A, committed the crime of infanticide. Bakit infanticide? Again, how old is that child? That child is only 2 days old. Therefore, the crime of infanticide is committed. But how about the penalty? Who is A? We are not sure if A is the father or the mother. But since he is related to the child, then the penalty corresponding to parricide shall be imposed. What if the accused in the crime of infanticide, or what if the person who killed the child is the mother? Pag nakakita kayo sa problem na ang pumatay is the mother, take note ha, mother, then you have to ask yourself, what is the purpose? What is the purpose of that mother in killing the child? Bakit? Because if the purpose is to conceal her dishonor, then iba ang penalty. But do not stop there. Bakit? Because you also have to ask, is the mother of good reputation and of good morals? If you are able to satisfy the two questions, then you will impose a different penalty. The penalty now is prison correctional in its medium and maximum period. But what if the mother is not of good reputation? What is the effect? If the mother is a prostitute, that means to say that she has no honor to conceal. Therefore, she is not entitled to a lesser penalty. How about if the accused or the person who killed the child is the maternal grandparents, the maternal grandfather or the maternal grandmother? Take note ha, maternal. Maternal sa side ng nanay. Hindi paternal, hindi sa side ng tatay. So if the accused or if the persons who killed the 3-day-old child is the maternal grandparents, then again, you ask the purpose. What was the purpose of the grandparents in killing the child? If the purpose is to conceal the dishonor of their child, then you impose also a lesser penalty, and that penalty is prison mayor. Let's go back to this 1982 bar question. We already discussed this when we were in parricide. So A here is a prominent and high official. He had an illicit relationship with B. Sino si B? B is a girl that is very much below the social standing of A. A child was born to them. But itong si A, he killed that child because he wants to conceal his dishonor. Question letter C. How would you answer the questions A if the child were less than the question A if the child were less than 3 days old? What crime did A commit in that case? The crime is infanticide. How about question B? If there is a relationship, would that constitute a privileged mitigating circumstance? Answer is no. Kailan lang nagiging mitigating circumstance? If the accused or the person who killed the child who is less than 3 days old is the mother and the maternal grandparents, then they can avail of that mitigating circumstance. But take note ha, that mother must be of good reputation and of good morals. And then you also have to ask, what is the purpose? What is the purpose of the mother in killing that child? With regard to the grandparents, maternal grandparents, then you also have to ask yourself, what was the purpose of the maternal grandparents in killing that child? Was it for the purpose of concealment, the dishonor of their child? Then they could avail of that mitigating circumstance. Going back to our problem, since ang pumatay is the father, and even if that purpose of the father is he wants to conceal his dishonor, still this could not be availed. The father could not avail of that mitigating circumstance. let's differentiate now parricide from infanticide. So first, what is the basis? The basis in parricide is always the relationship of the offender and the victim. How about in infanticide? What is the basis? The basis is the age of the child. Because if the child is less than 3 days old, then the crime is infanticide. How about if the child is no longer 3 days old, then the crime is parricide or murder. Next, who is the victim? Who is the victim in infanticide? Always the victim in infanticide is a child that is less than 3 days old. How about in parricide? The victim in parricide is not only against a child that is 3 days old or more or over, but also against other relatives. How about the offender? Who is your offender in parricide? The offender here is relatives enumerated under Article 246. The offender in infanticide is any person. Sabi nga natin, it can be committed by any person. How about the rule on conspiracy? Do you apply the rule on conspiracy in infanticide? Answer is yes. The rule on conspiracy applies. Only one information is filed against all offenders. How about in parricide? The rule on conspiracy does not apply because our basis is relationship. Therefore, if one of the accused is not related at all to the victim, then separate information must be filed for the homicide or murder committed by that non-relative conspirator. Let's read this 1997 bar exam question. We took this up when we were discussing parricide. So A here is a young housewife. Meron siyang paramour, si B. So they conspired to kill C, the husband to whom she was lawfully married. So A and B, they bought pancit and mixed it with poison. A gave the food with poison to the husband, but before the husband could eat the pancit, the illegitimate father and the legitimate son of A arrived. C, D, and E shared the food in the presence of A, who merely watched them eating. As a result, namatay si husband, namatay si illegitimate father, namatay yung anak because of that poisoned food. Question, what crime or crimes did A and B commit? Before we go to the answer, let us just change the facts. Let us just say that instead of pancit, naging gatas, milk. The milk was mixed with poison. And E here is now a child. I-change natin, gawin nating bata. Child si E. So in that case, what crime or crimes did A the mother and B the paramour now commit? Answer is depende. Bakit depende? Because the problem is not clear, hindi naka-indicate kung ang bata involved is less than 3 days old, then mag-iiba ang inyong answer. Bakit? Because if the son is less than 3 days old, then the mother is guilty of infanticide. How about B, the paramour? He is also guilty of infanticide. Ang sabi nga natin, the rule on conspiracy applies. The act of one is the act of all. Therefore, in this case, only one information is filed against A and B. Saan nagkakaiba? Nagkakaiba sa penalty. Bakit? Because if it is the mother who killed the child, then the penalty is that corresponding to parricide. Or let me just rephrase that. If it is the father, or other legitimate ascendants who killed that child, then the penalty is that corresponding to parricide. But in our problem, since it is the mother who killed that child, then what is the penalty? The penalty is prision correctional. That is considered a mitigating circumstance as long as that mother is of good reputation and of good morals, and the purpose is to conceal her dishonor. But take note again, ha? If she is a prostitute, then she must be a mother of not of good reputation and not of good morals. Therefore, she has no honor to conceal. Therefore, she is not entitled to a lesser penalty. Hindi niya maa-avail ang mitigating circumstance. But how about B, the paramour? What is now the penalty of B? Since B, the paramour, is not related to the child killed, then the penalty corresponding to murder shall be imposed. Next, how about if the son is exactly 3 days old or over? In that case, if the son is exactly 3 days old or over, then the mother is guilty of parricide. How about B? B is guilty of murder. Magkaiba silang dalawa. Si A is parricide, si B is murder. Bakit murder kay B? Because again, ano ang sinasabi natin? If you are going to kill a child of tender years, that is murder. Even if the manner of attack is not shown according to the Supreme Court, that is murder because your qualifying circumstance is treachery. At bakit sila magkaiba kay A parricide, kay B murder? Because the rule on conspiracy does not apply. It does not apply because the basis of the basis in parricide is always the relationship of the offender and the victim. Therefore, you have to file a separate information for murder to a non-relative conspirator.